Alright, so here we are in our first plant community of coastal sage scrub. Basically, everything that you see over here are the dominant plants of coastal sage scrub, even though it's probably one of the more endangered plant communities in the state. It's also the natural ecosystem or natural plant community that most Californians and most Southern Californians are likely to encounter because, well, a lot of our towns and cities are, you know, built in and around coastal sage scrub. So it's pretty fragmented landscape. And as you can see, most of these shrubs, you know, they get above your knees, but they don't get too much above your waist. You could actually walk through this area, unlike hard chaparral, which we're going to be looking at next. You know that you're really going through coastal sage scrub because it all smells really good. Now, unfortunately, our technology hasn't gotten so good that I can send you the smells of what I'm smelling. But, you know, if you know what sage smells like, and lavender, rosemary, they're all similar to that. Why do they smell like that? Well, basically because what you're smelling are the oils, okay? The oils of that are found in the leaves. The oils in the leaves of these plants keep the moisture in, okay? And that prevents moisture loss in the semi-arid seasonal climate where basically whatever little rain we get comes in the winter months, okay? And of course, the other thing also is that unfortunately that these oils also make these plants very flammable, okay? So in addition to the fact that it gets very dry for most of the year, it's also very prone to fire, okay? So, generally speaking, most of these plants are a little bit more gray-greenish in color. So this one right over here, that is California buckwheat. It's pretty common. It grows everywhere. Bees love it. They have small little clustered white flowers, which they don't have at this time of year. Probably the most common kind of plant in the coastal sage scrub is this, California sagebrush. Okay. This California sagebrush is related to the big basin sagebrush that you find all over the Intermountain West, all over states, everywhere ranging from the Sierra Nevada Mountains to Colorado, and even found on the other side of the San Gabriel Mountains. But this one is unique only to coastal California, coastal sagebrush. Smells good. It's a little bit more bitter than the next plant I'm going to show you here. So this is black sage, okay? You can see black sage. There are three kind of very common sages that you can find here in our coastal sage scrub. Black sage is, this kind of a little bit darker green. Purple sage is a little fuzzier, that's how you know it. And white sage is white leaves as it reflects a lot of the sun's energy, okay? This smells a lot better. I mean, the coastal sagebrush smells, California sagebrush does smell good, but this one smells more sweet. It is a little bit more truly like a true sage. It is a true sage. It is related to the sages that you would get at the grocery store. And finally, for a little bit larger shrubs, and some of the shrubs that you see there, this is also one of the more common shrubs, but it does grow a lot higher. And this is called Laurel sumac. Okay, Laurel sumac. And it also does have a pretty strong smell. It's a little bit, less agreeable to a lot of people. It's kind of has leaves that are shaped a little vaguely like a hard shell taco shell. But it does smell a little funkier. But it is very frost sensitive. It does grow a little bit above a lot of these other low shrubs of the coastal sage scrub. Now, why is a coastal sage scrub found here and not elsewhere? Well, basically, out of the four types of plant communities we're going to be looking at today, this most common one requires the least amount of moisture. A lot of these plants are usually the first one, not the first plants, but in an area of harder, denser chaparral, a lot of these plants like coastal sage scrub will start to recover after a wildfire. But they are usually found on soil as a little bit more clay, a little bit more where they don't have deeper roots, okay? Unlike the hard chaparral that we're going to be looking at later. That's a little bit about coastal sage scrub, okay? So we're going to be moving on to chaparral and then to oak woodland, and so we'll see you then.